Carlo Ancelotti is one of the all-time great managers. Now, we know he did some outstanding things with Real Madrid in 2022, but let's just speak about what he did from 2023 to 2024. In this season alone, he faced so many challenges. He faced so much adversity and still came out winning the Champions League, La Liga and Supercopa. First of all, Karim Benzema leaving the club. Benzema left in such a random moment, and it left the team in such a weird spot where we didn't have a number 9. What happened is, Real Madrid brought in Jude Bellingham and played him as an attacking midfielder, a position in which he never played in his career, and when he tested it out in pre-season, it didn't do too well, it wasn't too good in my opinion. We were losing a lot of pre-season matches. When the season happened, it didn't really feel like the team was gelling. It felt like we were depending on individual brilliance from Jude Bellingham, in which we were leaning on him to do that almost every single game. It got even worse when Vinny Jr. got injured, Odegaard got injured, Militao, Courtois, almost the entire squad got injured. And he had to make a lot of adjustments, using players like Oslo and Brahim Diaz, using bench players. And then they actually played well because Ancelotti knew how to use them. He knew how to use Brahim Diaz. Sometimes Oslo wouldn't put on good performances, but Ancelotti still put his trust in Oslo. And it worked out in the end. And when the players eventually returned from injury, they then slotted into the team so perfectly. And also, a big factor was Vinny Jr.'s injury. Vinny Jr. being injured showed how good Rodrigo is on the left side. And this is what made Ancelotti make some serious adjustments with playing Vinny and Rodrigo at the left. Now, I know this sounds crazy, but he actually did this. He would play Vinny Jr. at striker and Rodrigo at left wing. And it worked out. We beat Manchester City like this. We beat Leipzig like this and Bayern Munich. And on top of all that, when Odegaard came back, this man was benching Odegaard every single match. People were asking, why is Ancelotti doing this? They were saying, why are they benching this young prospect who looks like he's going to be a big deal? And this is where people don't look at why Ancelotti is the greatest coach of all time. He did not play this youngster, whereas a Barca coach would have a long time played this guy. No, Ancelotti says, he needs to get into proper fitness. He needs to build some more muscle and gain more weight. And it worked out. He has not gotten injured since then. And he's been scoring in almost every match for Real Madrid. Whereas many youngsters don't go through this process. They pick up massive injuries. And then they never get used. And now after the season, people are looking into when Kylian Mbappe joins the club, when Endrick joins the club. What is Ancelotti going to do now? People are saying they don't trust him. They don't know what he's going to do. Is he going to bench Rodrigo? How is he going to sort out the fact that Vinny and Mbappe both play their best at left wing? And let me tell you something. Just trust him. We didn't trust him at the beginning of the season. How players wouldn't perform at their best. With Mbappe, I think he will manage him perfectly. If there's any manager who can coach a great player like Mbappe, it's Ancelotti. Look at his resume. In all of the seasons he was at Real Madrid, when Cristiano Ronaldo was there, Ronaldo had his best individual seasons ever. Look at Benzema. Benzema had his best individual season under Ancelotti as well. And we can even go to AC Milan with Kaká. We can go to many other clubs and you will find a player who played at his best only under Ancelotti. And a super underrated thing that he does is that he gives these players freedom. Now, that doesn't work for everyone. It only works in a club with Real Madrid. Because these are players with the mentality, they know what to do. They don't need to be told what to do. And they are overall great individually. Whereas if you compare Ancelotti to a manager like Pep Guardiola, it's super different. Pep handles players who don't know how to play without the system. Now, I'm not saying they're bad players for that. You just get different situations. You get players who have the experience and know how to play on their own. And you get the ones that need a structure. and like to have a structure, and there's no problem with that. Pep Guardiola uses his players in a system, and people say it's robotic. People give so much criticism to it, but they still win every trophy. You get what I'm saying? They're winning every trophy. Why should they stop using those tactics? And I'm just going to say, since this current season, I will never doubt Ancelotti's plans ever again. We doubted him with the 4-4-2 diamond formation. We doubted him with the injuries. We doubted him even with the Arda Güler situation. And how did all those situations turn out? It turned out with these players playing their best football and everything going right. Nothing went wrong. And that's why for next season, with the Endricks and Mbappes, have patience, especially with Endrick. With him as a youngster, I know he puts on sometimes good performances for Brazil and Palmeiras. I know there's a lot of hype around him, but be patient. He might not play from the get-go, but you have to give him time. Ancelotti will know what he's doing. So overall, he's one of the greatest coaches of all time. You can argue with it, it doesn't matter. And up here is a new video. But if you enjoyed, smash like, subscribe, turn on notifications. Peace.